Volmer Jensen proves that there are no age limits in hang gliding. At 63, he has built one of the most efficient hang gliders in the world. The ship weighs about 100 pounds in dead air, but facing into a 15-knot wind will become weightless. Volmer has been building gliders all of his adult life, and actually built several hang gliders before World War II. When the hang glider movement was revived, he scaled down a conventional sailplane glider and mounted himself hanging under the wing instead of sitting in the cockpit. On the dashboard, he mounted a wind meter, altimeter, and a stick that controls the rudder, elevator, and ailerons. His ship falls only 1 foot for every 10 it goes forward, which enables it to keep gliding in light winds when others are forced to land. When Volmer flies over the Southern California hills, the sheep aren't the only ones who do double takes. Many middle-aged people see Volmer fly over their homes and get so curious they end up flying hang gliders themselves. At 63, Volmer Jensen continues to build and fly hang gliders and has no plans to retire. This sport is going to force a lot of people to redefine old age. At the other end of the age spectrum, but equally gifted, Taras Kasenik, at only 18 years old, designed and built this biplane he calls the Icarus II. It weighs only 55 pounds and can maintain in a 12-knot wind. Taras can sit up with the seagulls at Torrey Pines all day long if he chooses, and watch the kites below him. Since his father is the director of Mount Palomar Observatory, Taras has naturally had his eyes on the sky. After the Icarus II, he built an advanced monowing he calls the Icarus V. It is extremely stable due to the special warping of the wing. Taras was able to use Caltech's multi-million dollar computer to design the airfoil for this tailless glider. It weighs only 65 pounds, has a 10-to-1 glide ratio, and has gained thousands of feet in thermals when other kites are falling out of the sky. Taras is an unusually gifted contributor to the hang gliding movement. He has the coordination of a 20-year-old, the maturity of a 30-year-old, and the intellect of a 40-year-old. Add all of these up, and you get a 90-year-old aeromaniac. Another fixed-wing flyer, Mark Smith, is a model RC glider champion. He took one of his models and built it big enough to fly in it himself. Hanging only by his armpits and not strapped in, Mark felt a little queasy, thinking he might fall out. Every kid wonders what it's like to fly in a model. Now somebody knows. Building these advanced wings isn't as easy as it looks. Back in the good old days, hang gliders were made the night before a meet, using whatever materials you could beg or borrow. Consequently, you never flew any higher than you were willing to fall. Just about all of these early hang gliders could be folded up for easy storage. Let's face it, back in those days, getting up in the air really wasn't the problem. It was how you got back down. But the battle for the perfect landing goes on. There's nothing that quite equals the excitement and terror of your very first flight. Even an 80-foot sand dune looks like a mountain. At 15 years old, Ernie Fair was one of the youngest flyers around, and he was hoping that if he could only get through this moment, he would live to be one of the oldest. That's the wrong way, Ernie. But there comes a time in every young man's life when he must face that moment of truth. When the fog rolls in, flying activity generally comes to a halt, with a few minor exceptions. I tried to tell him. Some hang gliders are definitely not one-man operations. This one took a dozen guys and the world's longest rubber band to get it airborne. Back to the old drawing board. In contrast to these hang gliders, the great thing about a kite is that at 35 pounds, you can throw it on your back and go climb any mountain. Rich Piccirilli, a member of Jerry Bird's skydiving team, is also an avid kite flyer and likes to fly Death Valley on free weekends. Wills was at it again. He took a lightweight dirt bike, strapped a 12-foot kite to it, and set out after Evel Knievel. Off an 18-inch ramp on his first day out, Bob bested over 100 feet.
Beautiful!
Nothing
hey,
to
Bob,
it.
Come here.
After several hundred jumps at El Mirage Dry Lake, Bob wanted more distance. He streamlined his kite and put together a ramp four times the size of his old one. Feet. That's more distance. Bob wanted to try that one again. Hitting 65 miles per hour, completely wound out in fifth gear, Bob's bike begins to float even before it leaves the ramp. Once in the air, handlebars and brakes are useless for control, and Bob has to rely completely on weight shift to keep his 300-pound machine on course. Bob's best mark of the day was 301 feet, the length of a football field. In addition to his other claims to fame, Bob Wills runs the world's smallest airline. A pilot, co-pilot, a stewardess, and one passenger. Bob has managed to carry over 600 pounds with his 35-pound kite. On Bob's airline, their motto is, the stronger your grip, the longer your trip. Francis Edmer Gallo is the man who actually invented the kite concept. He and his wife built the first version as a toy for kids. When it outperformed all the other kites on the beach, NASA became interested and spent 10 years developing the concept in many forms, from motorized kites to giant regalo wing parachutes to bring back nose cones from space.
Well, when I was working at NASA, I felt that a flexible wing could be flared just like a bird does. But nobody would believe that that was possible because they hadn't seen a man do it.
Today, over 90% of all hang gliders are regalo wings. Mrs. Regalo had no idea when she sewed that first toy kite that it would become what it is today. Although Regalo originally developed the wing in his youth, he never actually tried flying one until he was over 60. Here he is preparing to make his very first flight. Just before he took off, he asked, "Are you sure these things fly?" Father of the kiting movement makes a perfect first flight and beams like a kid who has just learned to ride a bicycle. Mr. Regallo made his first flight look easy. But for most, it holds a lot of surprises. High winds can be dangerous. Chris Price decided to give it a try in a 50 mile an hour gale. In these conditions, kites have been known to flip end over end as soon as the kite is released. Chris just barely had enough penetration to keep the kite upright. Like giant invisible ocean breakers hundreds of feet high, rotors are formed as the air currents go up and over the cliff. If you fly too far in back of the cliff, these vicious turbulent downdrafts grab you without warning and thrash you against the ground. Chris Price was flying too far in back of the cliff. Fortunately, Chris didn't break anything except his control bar, but he was sore for a week. To avoid rotors, landing on top should be done as close to the edge as possible. Within reason, of course. But just like in jumping, they say that any landing's a good landing if you can walk away from it. Pat Canary, truly a superb kite flyer, likes to fly over Malibu, California, where he perfected his own specialty, standing in the control bar. This stunt is especially tricky, because if you should ever slip and fall in front of the bar, the kite will go into an uncontrollable power dive all the way to the ground. Pat took away Bob Wills' endurance record when he stayed aloft for nearly 5.5 hours. Pat said he could have stayed up longer, but he had a date that evening. Bob Wills just happened to be in Hawaii at the time when he heard that his record had fallen. Friends told him about some incredible cliffs over Waimanalo Bay. These cliffs are 1,000 feet sheer and face directly into the powerful trade winds which blow day and night. Sailplane pilots have known about this place for years, but this would be the first time anyone had ever attempted to jump off. When Bob stepped off the cliff at Waimanalo, he found himself sky surfing on the crest of an enormous wave of air. Hawaii is known for its big waves, but this is ridiculous. A 2,000 footer? But it was as smooth as glass and seemed to go on forever.
Head for the farthest shore. on the wind's wave. It's hard, sweetly how it sings. Rally each heart at the sight of your silver wings. Skybird, skybird, fly. Nightbird, find your way. For none may know it just as you may. Seek out your harbor of light.
Bob was cold and tired, but happy. He had stayed aloft for 8 hours and 24 minutes, almost doubling the record. It's been said that if man had been meant to fly, he would have been given wings. Well, in their own special ways, Bob Wills, Jerry Bird, and all the other skydivers and kite flyers have found their wings. Wings that have transformed the air above into a playground in the sky.